In this video, I'd like to talk to you about protecting your trees and shrubs from rodents. The two rodents that are the biggest problems are rabbits and voles. Now, it's early fall, and at this time of year, they're not going to bother your plants. There's enough green stuff laying around, they'll eat that instead. But as the winter carries along, there's less and less food for them to eat. And at some point they get so hungry, they will eat bark. There is some nutrition in bark. If you think about the way plants grow, right around the outside is the cambium layer. And that has sugars in them. So they like to come along and they chew the cambium off. They don't eat the whole trunk. They only chew the outer bark off. That's where the good food is. It's a good idea to protect some of your plants. Trees that are really tasty are all the fruit trees. So pears, apples, plums, they love going after those. Even crab apples are attacked all the time. This is a cornus, a flowering dogwood, and I wasn't sure whether they would go after or not, but I thought, I don't want to lose this plant, so just to be sure, I protected it. So what I did a couple years ago is I took chicken wire and I just made a cage around the plant. Because this is a shrub with multiple stems, it's really hard to use most of the other protections I'm going to show you. And chicken wire really works the best. Just make a large ring, close it off so they can't get inside of that ring, and then leave it. Now this has been on for a number of years, and so now I have a new problem. Some of the branches have grown through the holes. Now, ideally, you would take this off long before that, but this is out in my wooded area and I didn't notice it in time. In spring, what I'll have to do is come along and cut some of this wire off. I don't want the wire choking the new growth, but wire works really well. Now, when we're protecting for these rodents, you also have to think about where they are. So voles are tiny little animals and they're crawling along under the snow. They make tunnels, and they'll actually go under the snow, and they eat very low down. So whatever protection you use for those has to go right down to the ground. Otherwise, they'll just crawl underneath it. Now, rabbits are pretty big, and when they're standing on their hind legs, they're up to here or even higher. Now, if we get snow cover, and I've got snow up to here, the rabbits, they walk on top of the snow. So they're here, and then they stand up, they're going to get to here. You want to protect about a foot and a half to 2 feet above your high snow line. There's no point protecting down here for rabbits because rabbits won't dig in the snow. That's another reason I like chicken wire. Chicken wire is available in 4 foot lengths, which will give you a 4 foot height. And that's good for most areas, even if you have a fair amount of snow. So chicken wire is a very good option. Now let me show you some other options. This is an option I really like. This is drainage pipe and comes in very long lengths. You cut it to the length you want. Then I cut a slit up one side. The reason for the slit is twofold. One is that I can take it off after some branches grow above it. And the second reason is that if I leave it on the tree, it will expand as the trunk grows. And to be honest with you, I just leave these on all the time. This is a crab apple I grew from seeds about 12 years ago, and the trunk's getting a good size, and you can see how the plastic has expanded, and even though I left it on, it won't harm the bark. I mean, to be honest, I should take it off, and I probably will take it off in the spring. When we're protecting these plants from rodents, it's important to protect them in the first few years when the bark is softer and thinner. It's more likely that the rodents will eat the bark at that point. As the tree gets bigger, that bark gets thicker and less tasty to the rodents. So once it's this size, they won't bother the tree anymore, and I can simply take this all off. This is one of my eating apples, and to protect it, I covered it with the white plastic spiral that you can buy for trees. This is also a really good option. They're readily available in nurseries, and they're really easy to put on a tree. You just simply open the spiral a little bit and start winding around. It takes you a few seconds and you've covered the plant. As the trunk grows, it will slowly push against the spirals and open it up. So you can leave it on for a number of years. Most people recommend that you take them off in the summertime. If you don't take them off, there is a possibility that you'll get insects getting underneath the plastic, and that may damage the trunk. To be honest with you, I just put them on and leave them. Rodent damage is pretty easy to prevent. Unfortunately, most people don't think of it until springtime, when they come out and the snow melts and they see the damage. Then it's too late. Now, I'd like to show you some rodent damage, but it's fall and I don't have any at this time of the year. I only see it in the spring. Now, a few years ago, we must have had a really cold winter because several of my evergreens were damaged. And rodents don't like evergreens. They don't taste very good. But there were a few damaged. So I don't usually protect evergreens. It's mostly the deciduous plants that I'm concerned about. But you never know. When you're hungry enough, you eat almost anything. Now, if you want to learn more about taking care of trees and shrubs, I'll put a link to my other videos in the top right-hand corner. I have a whole series of pruning videos, and I made one a couple years ago about taking care of multiple leaders. That's something you need to correct right away. And this is actually the evergreen I used. We had a big second leader coming here, and I took it out. The leader that was left has grown nice and straight and strong. And in a few years, you won't even notice that cut. Multiple leaders is something you can fix very easily and is really important for the tree. But you have to do it early on. You can't wait for several years and then try to correct it. It's too late. Winter is coming. There's not much for you to do outside in the garden. So here's a suggestion. Sit down and watch all of my pruning videos. The link to that is in the top right-hand corner. Have fun sitting inside beside your fireplace and dreaming about gardening. See you next time.